the skill set and the tool set that we need in order to establish our office and to raise funds for our apostolate in education.
It was very chaotic. Before spring rain, we were just scrambling and trying to figure things out. Where spring rain came and gave us the technology on how to run it properly. We had departments, roles, and it was an organized machine where it's just like a business or any entity that it would function on its own. Even if one person's not there or the president is not there, the foundation is constantly moving and functioning.
For the new PDOs, the resources that you have will be maximized because of the system that Spring Rain will teach you and will share with you.
The system has helped us how to pool resources, how to manage the fund, how also to manage our advocacies, our activities and program, how to sustain it, and plans are being done for its continuity.
I would like to invite you to engage with Spring Rain and help the people, your community, more with the system.
Without the system, it will block succession. If you have the right skillful people without the system, then it cannot sustain long enough. If you have a system without the right people, then you miss the opportunity of maximizing the whole process. There's a lot of donor fatigue that is happening right now. And it's not because they don't want to give. It's about being annoyed by the manner of asking. It's actually the manner of the way we are communicating with the donor.
The perennial problem that we have been encountering is the problem of sustainability. Partly because we haven't nourished and nurtured relationships with our different benefactors all these years. That's when I see the great potential that once we are able to connect and to nurture our relationship with our donors and eventually make their donation, make their giving more of a happy experience, then probably things will be better. So that it doesn't become a linear type of relationship, but it becomes a mutual kind of relationship. When the donor gives, he is happy because he was able to give, and of course he is happy that he is being regularly updated by the happenings and the updates of the foundation itself.
We are able to see more people who are really not only business driven, but deep inside they want to make their businesses even more meaningful. They are finding meaning on giving impact to the lives of others. It ignites more our desire to do mission, to expand our mission. We are very excited to continue doing it and to be more serious about it.
It takes a way to really study them and learn about how these donors need to get motivated, get involved, so that the fatigue that is happening will turn into a transformation of partnership, love, generosity, and it will create a very wonderful family in the world of philanthropy.
years of faith, grateful today. We bear the gift of mission, totally yours to give ourselves, faithfully yours till the end. To your mission, Lord, we give our yes.
Go where the sun rises above the hills. Share the word and serve those who are in need. Let the morning star accompany your way. Spread the fire of mission for the Lord.
We stand before the grand horizon. 500 years of faith, grateful today. We bear the gift of mission, totally yours to give ourselves, faithfully yours until the end. To your mission, Lord, we give our yes.
We are gifted. Compassion, justice, and peace. The sign the world today will come to believe is the love we have one and all.
We bear the gift of mission.
Good evening, everyone. Good morning and good afternoon to those who are joining us from other parts of the world. Welcome to the second day of Spring Rain Global's 45 days of Lenten spiritual journey and Holy Week. Reflections for the grace of the 500 years of Christianity. Before we proceed, may I request everyone to please mute your microphone as soon as you log in to ensure the solemnity of the recollection. We encourage you to invite your family and friends to join us in this one-of-a-kind Lenten spiritual journey. We are live every day via Zoom and on Facebook via the Spring Rain Global page. We will now have our opening song followed by the Spring Rain Global prayer.
Recording. Recording.
So proud, my mind is so unfocused. I see the things you do through me. It's great things I have done, and now you gently break me and lovingly. Ask you how many times will you pick me up when I keep on letting you down, and each time I will fall short of your glory. How far will forgiveness abound? And you answer my chant, I love you, and as long as you're seeking really means the price that I could could never pay was paid at Calvary. So instead of trying to repay you, I'm learning to simply obey you by giving up my life to you for all that you've given to me. I ask you, how many times will you pick me up? And I keep on letting you down. And each time I sufficient grace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Spring Rain Global Prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to be called in this noble endeavor of serving people and organizations through our thrust for a deeper love for humanity and stewardship of our giftedness. As we respond to this ministry each day, fill us with the power of the Holy Spirit, that your wisdom may enlighten us, that your strength may remind us to stay focused in our purpose and calling, that your light be our guide at all times, and that your love be in our hearts. We know that the journey may not always be easy, but we firmly believe and hold on to your promise that you will be with us both in our challenges and victories as we bring love and unity to your people in service for others. We continue to pray that as we grow the mission and purpose of our Spring Rain Global family, we may be sustained by your grace, ready to open the path for others, so that your blessings and divine providence may completely flow to each and every one of us. May we always stay in your grace, now and forever. This we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We will now play the national anthems of the Philippines, U.S., and Singapore to signify the countries where Spring Rain Global is registered and operating.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Streaming
Tonight's speaker will be guiding us on the theme of the 45 days of Lenten spiritual journey, a reflection of grace of the 500 years of Christianity. We will be guided in our reflection by Father Victor Gonzaga, OSA, Prior of the Community Colegio San Agustin, Mati City, Davao Oriental, and the Chairman of the Advisory Board, Spring Rain Global. Father Victor, good evening.
Hello, Anne. Good evening to our brothers and sisters in the Philippines. Good evening. And the rest of our participants from other parts of the globe. Good morning and good afternoon. Thank you for joining us tonight. This is the second day of our journey in preparation for Easter. I am very grateful to God for this opportunity to be part of this journey with you, reflecting the many, many teachings of the church, which I think very necessary to be reminded. So before I start, allow me to dedicate this sharing or reflection to our brothers and sisters who are currently suffering in the midst of war. It is not easy for our brethren to be in that kind of situation. And I dedicate this reflection, this session, this evening, for those people who are suffering. Secondly, I ask all participants to pray and remember at least 5 members of your respective family, those people who have gone ahead of us. Let us offer prayers and let us remember our brothers and sisters who are now in the loving embrace of God. The topic that is given to me is precisely the title of our Lenten journey, Reflection for the Grace of the 500 Years of Christianity. I have 7 points that I would like to share with you tonight. The first point is enduring gratitude for our Christian faith. Recognizing our giftedness of our own life, community, and country. There's so much gift that we receive. For our life, basically, we know Christ as our Lord and Savior. Probably it sounds not so important because that reality, that dignity, is already given to each one of us long before we become conscious of our life. But we need to recognize that it's a very precious gift to recognize Jesus as our Lord and Savior in our own life. Imagine if the missionaries did not arrive in the Philippines. Probably, we don't have that idea. So it's a gift that is given to us that we ought to recognize. For our community, for our Christian community, we lived and we shared Christian values, which are very precious in our day-to-day life existence. Christian values that we have, sometimes overlooked, sometimes not practiced, sometimes less appreciated. But these are the values that guided, governed our way of life. And again, we ought to recognize and appreciate such giftedness in us. As a country, Philippines, we are proud we are happy to be the biggest Catholic country in Asia. There's another Catholic country, Timor-Leste, in the heart of Indonesia, but the population of that country is quite small. So when we speak of Catholic country or Catholic presence in Asia, it would be the Philippines that would be part of the discussion. So it's a gift, again, as a nation, as a country, we are given such a special privilege to be the light, to carry the name of Jesus in the heart of Asia. Recognizing our giftedness, that is very, very important. Our journey together in this season of Lent should be a manifestation of a life that is grateful. Not only do we have a litany of petitions or requests to God, but to show our gratefulness to God for everything in our lives. Probably many of us are desiring to be part of the day, the daily recollection from yesterday, March 2, until the end, on April 15. That's a 45-day journey. Because we have petitions, we are asking God for a specific favor. But I think in order of priorities, I think it would be better and more appropriate if we engage, if we allow ourselves to be part of this journey with the intention of showing our deep gratitude to God for the many blessings that we have received. We are still in the midst of the pandemic. There is war going on in Europe and in other parts of the world. We cannot fully claim we are very away from them. We are very much connected with their government, their economy. And so it is very difficult to assume that we are safe here while some of our brothers and sisters in other parts of the world are struggling because of war. Again, let us clearly understand that in this journey, it can help us see very clearly the power of a grateful heart for those who follow Jesus Christ. And then comes our petitions, our prayers, our quote-unquote negotiations with God. But at the beginning of this journey, it is very important to recognize that we have received from God our giftedness, our person, our family, our 500 years of celebration. And then from there, we ask God, we negotiate God, we ask favor from Him, we ask guidance. But it would be very appropriate if we begin this journey with a very clear intention of showing our gratitude to God for so many blessings that we have received. My second point, a journey towards a deeper introspection. The best moment to plunge into the deep. Duk in altum. Into the inner of our person, of our being. It's not when we are troubled or in pain. Rather, when we are grateful and victorious, when our lives are okay, when we are succeeding with our goals in life, and we are celebrating, that is the moment I would prefer to say, I think that's the best moment. We need to silently journey back within and see very clearly the source of such joy, the source of such success, the source of such victory in your life. When I was in Cebu, we used to organize events, gathering. In 2015, in the celebration of the 450th anniversary of the presence of the Augustinians, we organized an international gathering for the youth and the vocation promoters. It was not easy. It was really very difficult hosting about 700 youth participants coming from all over the country, the Philippines, and participants from Indonesia. At the same time, hosting the presence of about 80 vocation directors, directress, Augustinian sisters, brothers, and priests, coming from 24 countries in 6 continents. For 5 or 6 days. And in the midst of that, I would say success, meaningful success. Every time before I go to my room, I go down to the Pilgrim Center at the Basilica del Santo Niño. Around 12 or 1 in the morning or even 2 in the morning. And pray silently, recalling the events of the day, the challenges, the difficulties, the decisions we have made, and thanking God for such a blessing. The following day, there's so much energy, there's so much power. You are refreshed, or I was refreshed. There's so much connection between the source of the grace and the recipient of the blessings of God. Very important to allow ourselves, especially when we are expressing our gratitude, to go deep within and discover the source of such joy and celebration and victory in your life. Comes Holy Week, we are preparing for the so-called El Camino de Santo Niño here in Makati City. It's a 27-kilometer walk from 10 o'clock in the evening until the morning of the following day. That is a journey of introspection, of going within, thanking God for the many blessings we receive, but at the same time, deepening our relationship with God. That is a kind of an example that we can allow ourselves to go into the deeper part of our soul, of our being, and appreciate the source of our joy and happiness in life. In that way, my dear brothers and sisters, we are deeply and intimately anchored on the source of our life, the source of our blessings and success in life. Most often, when we are grateful and joyful, we manifest it in our festive celebrations, food, wine, party, outing, celebrations. Rarely do we embark on a journey within. This Lenten 45-day recollection, thanks to SRG, is one of the transforming way to journey back within. This is not easy, attending recollection every night for 45 days. For some of you, I know you are part of our journey when it comes to fasting for the next 45 days. I recognize there are some members of our community who are joining in this session tonight. It's quite meaningful to look forward that in the next 45 days, I'll be part of that community that journeys together, attending, participating, recollection every night, and doing fasting, or almsgiving, or prayers for our dead loved ones and our brothers and sisters who are suffering because of war, injustice, economic problems, because of the pandemic, and any other reasons. So meaningful that we allow ourselves to spend an hour and a half for that spiritual undertaking that we need to equip ourselves with. This should be our point of view and direction as we celebrate the 500 years or the closing of the 500 years. Let us take steps backward and fully recognize our personal, communal, and even national as a country giftedness, the giftedness in us, and gearing towards our common mission for humanity. We can better understand how blessed we are, how gifted we are, how God has taken care of each one of us in this journey when we allow ourselves to spend time to go within and discover the source of everything. My third point, my dear brothers and sisters, is about walking together as children of the one God. This is a very clear agenda of our beloved Pope Francis in the next few years towards the Synod on Synodality. Again, we are grateful because we are part of this journey. We are invited. We were not sidelined or marginalized. We were included. We were consulted. The entire church was consulted. The whole church is mobilized and oriented towards the theology and mindset of walking together. We are all into this journey, into this El Camino, the way, the journey, the walking together. SRG's motto, Spring Rain Global, has this motto: no one should be left behind in our work, in our philanthropic initiatives and work. We are constantly reminding ourselves that in our dedication and in our effort in our desire to help different organizations, we need to be reminded that no one should be left behind. Creating an ecosystem or a variety of organizations desiring to create an environment that is inclusive and no one should be left behind. That is, I think, a very important, vital component of walking together, the sense of inclusiveness, the inability to reject others because of their colors, languages, culture, and even faith. This, the spirit of walking together invites every one of us to invite and engage the people within our community, within our faith community, and even outside of our faith community, even those who are non-believers. It's so powerful that the Pope has framed the entire agenda of the church, not just opening windows and doors, but walking together with people inside the community and even outside our own community. When we are grateful, we see our differences in a positive light. We become tolerant. We become appreciative of the ways of others, of the challenges of others. But when we are ungrateful, that's why my first point earlier was about gratitude. Because I think in this celebration, in this 45-day Lenten journey, and in the bigger celebration of 500 years, gratitude is very important because it unlocks, it opens the door for many recognition and we are able to appreciate what we are celebrating because we have a grateful heart. So when we are ungrateful, we can hardly recognize the value and dignity of others, much more their unique contribution in our life, in our society, and in the church. If we are ungrateful, chances are we appreciate less, or we do not appreciate the people probably around us, those who are different from us, those who are worshiping God, acting in a different way from our way of life. So because when we are grateful, we see the differences in a positive light. And we recognize their goodness, their dignity, and probably their own God and their way of life. Brothers and sisters, let us be a Catholic or a believer of Christ that is open and willing to walk together with and for others. Many global conflicts we are witnessing today are happening because many of our world leaders are not willing to walk together with and for others. They become exclusive, choosy. They create criteria, standard that would alienate others and protect their sense of security by their exclusiveness. the invitation of our beloved Pope to walk together is very, very powerful. I hope and pray our world leaders, our national politicians will appreciate the theology, the spirit behind walking together. There's so much communion. There's so much love. There's so much care for others when we engage in walking together. The fourth point that I have is SRG's unique spiritual contribution to humanity. Brothers and sisters, allow me to highlight this one as a model and as an example of other organization. Allow me to mention this aspect of our Catholic journey because it underlines the powerful role and contribution of the lay members of our church. Oh, I'm sorry, I was jumping. For a moment of renewal for our faith. This is my fourth point. This 45-day Lenten recollection is a powerful and effective tool to refresh ourselves and renew the basic of our faith. In the next 43 days, we will be listening to the different reflections and sharing by our different speakers from all over the world, reflecting about the Ten Commandments, the Seven Sacraments, the Beatitudes, the 14 Works of Mercy. And these are the things that are very basic in our Catholic faith. And we need to have a moment of renewal for our faith in the celebration of the 500 years. We need to go back to the basic. Otherwise, this basic, this very important teachings of our Catholic faith might be sidelined, if not forgotten. Celebrating the fifth centenary of our Catholic faith is a perfect opportunity to refresh ourselves closer to the roots of our faith. As an institutional church, we need to invest time and resources in order to cultivate and recultivate the basic teachings of our faith. Otherwise, there's a higher chance that these things will not be appreciated by young Catholics like our children and grandchildren. These things, the Ten Commandments, the sacraments, the works of mercy, are oftentimes not being discussed in the usual narrative of our day-to-day life existence. We need to bring this to our attention, especially in the context of celebrating the 500 years. If you can see during the celebration of the feast in our town, mostly we celebrate it with a lot of cultural activities, sometimes misgay, sometimes disco, and all the other social activities that we can imagine. we rarely heard a parish or a school community or a parish community, for example, having Bible quiz or quiz on the basis of the life of the saints, the Bible, and other things that are basic in our Catholic faith. Probably, if we go back within and try to evaluate and assess and analyze our way of life, probably we can learn something by going back, by renewing the basic teachings of our faith, by allowing ourselves to be refreshed by the basic teachings of our Catholic faith. In that way, we have a new perspective, a new understanding of the giftedness that we have because of our faith. Let us not allow political issues, social concern that will hinder us from desiring to be engaged or to be, how do I say this one, to be reminded of the basic teachings of our Catholic faith. I intentionally include this in one of my points precisely to remind all of us the importance of this. Even me as a priest, when I was reviewing all these things, it gave me a different perspective of the giftedness that I have as a Catholic and as a Catholic priest. The graces, the blessings of God are integrated into this basic teachings of the church that most of us neglect or overlook because we might be too busy or we are focusing on many other complicated things about our life. The fifth point that I have here is SRG's unique spiritual contribution to humanity. I said spiritual contribution because SRG is indeed very unique in their vision of the company, of their desire to be an active agent or contributor in the life formation of the member of the Catholic Church. Allow me to mention this aspect of our Catholic journey because it underlines the powerful role and contribution of the lay members of the church. We need the lay people in the many challenges we are facing. This is our second run or edition of the 45-day Lenten journey. Last year, we started this one, and this is the second time. And there's no company in the Philippines that I know, or even outside. There's no diocese or even congregation that dares to have this very long recollection. This is a very bold step. Very daring, and I would say very expensive and very complicated. Imagine dealing 45 speakers or 40 plus speakers coming from different parts of the globe and create one unified program, event, or undertaking that will deepen the spirituality of the people. That's something very unique and spiritual. And indeed, a contribution not only to our community, not only to our country, but to the entire humanity. And that is done by a lay organization. The church, the Catholic Church, needs the participation, contribution, and involvement of the lay people. They are doing this all in the name of deepening our spirituality, as well as gradually cultivate the ground so that giving or philanthropy can grow and be understood clearly and can be practiced by all believers. You know, during the pandemic, many of our parishes were confused. They don't know what to do, especially on sustaining their pastoral ministry, because there's no masses. If our parishioners were equipped with the basic processes of how to help our parish community, probably we were not able to encounter those challenges. But thanks be to God for, or thanks to the pandemic, I would say, sorry for that word, it awakens us. It gives us a different perspective on how to cultivate our own parish in order to allow our people, our lay people, to be creative, to find new ways of giving meaning and life in the parish, on how to involve themselves in these challenging times because of the pandemic. And I think SRG have done something that can serve as a model and example for all of us, for all our parish communities, school communities, or faith-based communities. It is very important that we see a lesson here, an example that is given by this particular team or group of people. They did not stop. In fact, they reinvent themselves. They innovate. They face the challenge squarely. And in the process, they have discovered unique ways, smart ways of sustaining our mission, of allowing us to be more active in our spiritual formation, in our parish life, even if there are challenges created by the pandemic. So in the celebration of the 500 years, it is important to note and recognize the works of these people, hoping that it will inspire more and more lay people, organizations, companies, from focusing their resources towards the advancement of our Christian faith. It is a rare opportunity for us to see a company working with so much dedication for the deepening of our spiritual formation, making us aware of the importance of spiritual life in the survival of our own family, in the survival of our own country. So Spring Rain, thank you for that contribution. I said unique spiritual contribution to humanity, because you have done something that inspired people. Actually, we have no idea how many people are or will be inspired by what we are doing here. Last year, last Advent, last year Lenten, and last year Advent, and this year's Lenten celebration, Lenten journey. The possibility is immeasurable. God knows. God will guide these people to be inspired. At least on our part, we are engaged here in this conversation, in this Lenten preparation, in this deepening of our spirituality, because we wanted to become a better person. In my case, a better priest, or a better mother or father, or a member of your community. My next point is about sustaining the ecosystem of good. Needless to say, the world today is faced with the very huge challenges that require us for us to have a collective response. We cannot afford to solve social problems relying only with our personal or congregational or parish diocesan resources. We need an ecosystem, an active and very supportive constituency in order to address the many challenges like the post-pandemic economic, educational, political, environmental, and security situations. Here at SRG, in this family and in this movement, I say movement, we create a structure and mechanism in order to support and sustain the ecosystem of good. There is so much war and conflict already. I think it's safe to assume that the participants here are desiring, praying, wishing to have a peaceful world, a world with love, devotion, care, and joy and freedom. But our world is so difficult. War from all the corners in the world. Conflict. Economic problems. And many, many huge challenges that we are facing. People from different religious and political affiliations, varied nationalities, cultures, and ministries or apostolate, yet one and the same desire to help humanity. That is the people behind this ecosystem of good. To all the participants of this recollection, I invite you to be in whatever capacity you are. Please be part of that movement, of that people desiring to contribute something for the betterment of humanity. I understand our government, non-government organization, and church organizations or groups are doing their best in order to bridge the gap. But in spite of the collective effort, the number of homelessness, or the homeless people rather, is increasing. The school dropouts is increasing. Unemployment is rising. It is in this light that we need to continue moving in this direction in order to help the different organizations, whether government or non-government organization, or church-based organization to sustain the works of their own organization. It is very important that we help one another. We create an ecosystem that we can help each other. We can help prevent or solve, at least contribute to the solution of homelessness, starvation, food security, challenges that our brothers and sisters from IP community are facing, environmental challenges, mining, and many other social problems that we have. We need to work together. We need to sustain that ecosystem of good. And exactly the thing that we are doing right now is a step forward to realizing, to strengthening that ecosystem of good that the human, that our civilization badly needs. My dear brothers and sisters, it is very important that given the celebration of the 500 years, we are grateful to God for such giftedness. But we have to be mindful also with a bigger mission ahead. We are not given such a wonderful gift, or we are not gifted for nothing. We are given such blessings and giftedness because of a mission. That's my last point, the global mission. Our mission is both personal and global. We cannot allow ourselves to be just relegated in the boundaries of our localities. Every action or inaction will have a closer impact to the communities around us, even globally. This 45-day recollection started with the idea of quenching our spiritual thirst for renewal, for the presence of God, for wisdom, for understanding, for deeper clarity about my faith and our personal journey. The need to be spiritually transformed. We are looking for more ways to provide us meaning in life and in our journey. That's the beginning of the conception of this idea. But this 45-day Lenten recollection became much bigger eventually. It involves a lot of people, different nationalities, participating. And I would say it's part of the global mission. It's part of our being connected with each other. It's part of our being Catholic. That is the real meaning of being Catholic, to be universal, to be part or to be connected with others universally. Hence, what happens to Ukraine, Yemen, to the Uyghur brothers and sisters, our Muslim brothers and sisters in China, the threat to Taiwan and South China Sea, are not any more local or regional matters. It becomes part of our own existence, no matter how far it is from us. In the celebration of the 500 years, we assert our identity as Catholics with so much gratitude to God. So much gratitude to God. But at the same time, it also reaffirms our commitment in the global mission of the Church and in the areas of spiritual renewal, environmental protection, social justice, peace and mutual respect, and philanthropic initiatives to create community development and sustain our apostolate. We are part of the bigger story. That's why Pope Francis said, walking together. We are all into this walking together. We are part of the global mission. Do not underestimate who you are. Father, I'm just a lay coordinator in our BEC or basic ecclesial community. Father, I'm just a lector. Father, I'm just a member of our church. I don't have any position. Each one of us, in the celebration of the 500 years, each one of us is invited to walk together, walking together towards that global mission of the Church. In this Lenten journey of 45 days, the blessings, the renewal, and the transformation is not only about you and the members of your own family. This is also about the global mission of our own church for the welfare of every member of humanity. This is our responsibility. This is the effect of our giftedness. As I said earlier, we are not given such a wonderful gift for nothing. We are gifted. We are blessed to be part of the mission of the Church. Thank you, and in Deum. I have two guide questions for our reflections. Miss Klein, can you share that guide questions? First, with your current situation in life, wherever you are right now, how can you personally involve in the mission of your local church? Local church. And then the second, recognizing our own giftedness in the celebration of the 500 years of Christianity, how can you engage or be a part of the global mission of the Church? Thank you. Thank you. Let us pray. Loving and gracious Father, we thank you for the opportunity. We thank you for the desire that you have given to each one of us to be part of this recollection tonight. Give us the strength to continue the journey. Inspire us. Awaken the power in us so that we will allow ourselves, in spite of our limitations, weaknesses, and fears, encourage us to be part of your global mission. Remove our fears, our hesitations, our doubts. On the strength and the capacity of your graces in our lives. Lord, give us the courage to embrace you and to fully trust your blessings in our lives so that we will become contributors to the realization of the glory of your kingdom here on earth. Loving Father, we deeply express our gratitude to you for such an amazing journey for the past 500 years of our Catholic faith in our country. Strengthen us so that we can make bold decisions that will advance the global mission of our church for the greater glory of humanity. Use us. Use our limitations, our weaknesses, our failures, our person, our being, to be an instrument so that millions of people will become closer and closer to the presence of your holy name and your Son, Jesus Christ. This we ask through Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Thank you very much, Father Victor, for your reflection and sharing. Indeed, we should walk together regardless of race, color, or religion, as we are all children of the one God. The Catholic Church needs the involvement of the lay people, like what SRG is doing. Its unique spiritual contribution to humanity is truly inspiring. Thank you everyone for joining us this evening. May we request everybody to turn on their cameras for our picture taking. Turn on your cameras po.
Camera, please. Show us your beautiful smile. 1, 2, 3, smile. One more, 1, 2, 3, smile. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Please join us again tomorrow, 8 p.m. Philippine time, here at Zoom or via the Spring Rain Global page for the third day of Spring Rain Global's 45 Days of Lenten Spiritual Journey and Holy Week, Reflections for the Grace of the 500 Years of Christianity. Tomorrow's topic is a reflection on prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. We will be guided in our reflection by Father Czar Emmanuel Alvarez, OSA, the Vice President for Academic Affairs, Colegio San Agustin Binyan. We hope that you will invite your family and friends, and together let us nurture our love, faith, hope, and devotion to the Lord. May God continue to bless the work of our hearts and hands. Thank you, and see you all tomorrow. We will now play our closing song.
500 years, awesome to behold. He has made us all new, we belong to this fold.
The gospel is a blessing, but also a mission. To the poor and the children, we bring His salvation.
To the rest of the world, His message of compassion. To all of humanity, His challenge of
everyone. Good night. Thank you, Father Victor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father Victor.
Thank you so much. Salamat po, everyone. Brother Rene, salamat.
Thank you, Father Victor.